Welcome back to the shop at Jet City. What's been happening recently in this shop is you can't see it because it's all in pieces. We are rebuilding another turbojet engine for a Saber and a Render 14. And I think what we're gonna do next is take apart the combustors and get these things out of the inside of them, the combustor liners, which is a very important part of the engine. We're gonna be going through that in great detail. Like we just finished with the main drive shaft, which connects the back end to the front end, the turbine to the compressor. This thing, I've got it wrapped in plastic on the splines here, transmits 18,000 and change horsepower, over 12,000 pounds feet of torque at 7,800 RPM. So we're gonna take a look at the brand new piece that we found that we're going to be putting in this engine. It connects right here, the back end to the front end. Hang on a second. All right, this part is the main flexible coupling, and it slides onto the other end of the shaft over there, which is a similar spline. Right here, I'm going to get all sticky because this is actually pretty old. It's brand new, but it's packed in cosmoline, which is like a brown waxy goop, so there's no rust at all. This is a very recent part. This is December 1967. So what's that? 55 years. It's only 55 years old. Easy, brand new. I'm gonna have to go to the Varsol tank and get this stuff off because it's like caramel. But anyway, always nice to have the main driving parts of your jet engine to be brand new. Yeah. So I'll put a couple minutes of footage of the process of overhauling this shaft right now. We're gonna tighten this up and see if it holds it down hard or forcefully enough to make our anti-torque device work. It might try to climb up this little ramp here. Oh, that was easy. So nice soft smashing device. A bit of a spigot on there, which is helping to mount and centralize it. There we go. Oh, this is heavy. There. It's all right. It's less rusty than I expected. The masking took way longer than the painting. Of course, I masked off all the threads. So there we go. Go. Let's hope this goes well. Great. Oh, let's make sure it goes the right way. Oh, look at that. So you can see the little circlip groove right there. Check back when this cools down. My hope is somebody sees that 50 years from now. Okay, go like, there we go. Happiness. Okay, so we're just gonna lightly hand thread this on so it maintains position. We won't do any actual torquing for. Okay, so like that. Here we go. If you wanna see more videos about refurbishing the jet engine, the turbojet engine from the beginning to the end, you want to check out my Patreon channel. I'll let you know it's much more detailed. The video about this shaft, the actual video is over 90 minutes long, or almost 90 minutes long. That's right, almost 90 minutes long. So a lot of detail. It's like being on my shoulder when I work on stuff. Anyway, check that out if you think you're interested. Can always use more supporters on Patreon. And today we've got a couple things to do with general updates. We've got some flags sent to us by some friends. And also the weather has changed, so the snow is mostly gone, almost all gone. And a couple days ago I was out riding on the local mountain bike trails. And I was very disappointed to learn that more and more people are discovering the trail for a walking path. And I'm not saying who's doing who's doing what to what or who's putting what where, but there was a lot more garbage this year. So there I was. I usually carry a little garbage bag, and I picked up some things, went back to my truck, and I actually parked my truck right by the side of the road where the trail entrance is, because I had to pick up probably 5 to 10 pounds of garbage in the side of the road. So I was nearly done picking up the garbage, and it was a beautiful, breezy, sunny day, and I saw something fluttering up in the grass about 20 yards away. So I thought it was a cigarette package, a bit of gold, a bit of silver, shiny object flapping in the wind. So I go over there and I think, oh, it's probably a scratch and win lottery ticket because it's got like a little hologram on it. And I couldn't believe it. It looks like karma decided I was doing something right because it was this. Seriously, I couldn't believe it. I thought it was an advertisement. That's a $100 bill. And luckily, Canadian money's plastic, so it doesn't get damaged by sun and wind and rain. So thank you, karma. I guess I was doing something right that day. Yeah, that made me feel good. So the next thing we're going to talk about is it's been a while since we had any flags show up. So we've had three recently. This one is sent to me by, it's a Thailand flag. It's from Thailand. That's what it says in the return postage. And the back says, from the wayward Wyoming wench. And I'm going to guess that is Sheila. Just going to guess. I haven't really opened it yet. It says via the Perth to Paris puddle jumper. So that must be an aircraft that goes from Australia to France, I guess. I'm going to guess it's a 777. But that's all that's on here. So if it wasn't Sheila that sent me this, I apologize. Is there a note? There's no note. We've got this. This is it says it's a Thailand flag. I'll have to check. Have I got it? I don't think I've got it upside down or backwards. Very cool. Thank you, Sheila, I guess. I think it's Sheila. My girlfriend, Sheila. Okay, on to the next one. This is gonna go nicely up there somewhere. We're running out of room, but that's okay. It's always good to have friends send flags. We have from Robert. Oh, there's a couple of them in here. Holy cow. Well, now I'm in trouble because I don't know what they all are. I think this is May 1975 to April 1776. I'm getting so confused. Anyway, I think this is a North Carolina flag or something like that. Please, somebody let me know. I'm going to look it up, but it's always nice to have it identified by people who live there and know their stuff. So, he sent a bunch of flags. Okay, what's this one? Is that South Carolina? I'm only guessing. I shouldn't guess because I'll just make a fool of myself. There's no label. Yeah. Okay, that one did have a note, and it is the North Carolina and South Carolina flag. So sorry for not recognizing that instantly. I'm from a long ways away. This is Western. It's not Northern Canada. It's way up north to the States. We're kind of in the middle of the Canadian geography, but far to the west. So thanks to Robert. And our final flag is, it's from California Aerofab, and I think it's gonna be huge. I think it's a California flag, but we'll see. I have not opened this to see what it is. It's huge. It's a real flag from a flagpole. So. It's very large, so big, it's much bigger than me. Yeah, that's what it is. Hopefully you guys can see this. I'm going to stop this for a second and string this up so that we can see it. Hang on a second, hang on. Okay, how's that? It's still touching the floor. And what is it? I don't know, 12, 16 feet wide and 8 feet tall. It's pretty big. If you're gonna send a flag here, this is ridiculous. I appreciate it. I don't know where I can put it. As a matter of fact, the perfect size flag here, it's not the California flag, it's the United States of America, the first one to go up there. next to the Canadian flag, which is a little bit small, next to the British flag, which is a little bit big. I'll show you that in just a second. Am I here? I'm there. Okay, so the first flag that was sent to us was United States of America, a very nice sewn together flag. Then I put up the Canadian flag, which was a little small, and then they started showing up in this, I guess, 3x5 size. There's France, Britain, Germany, Norway. Those are a little too big, but they're okay. Hey, flash fast forward to the future. It's the next day, and I did find a spot for it. Covers the whole door, and we're gonna see how it works when I raise the door, but I think it's gonna be okay. So I shouldn't have been so pessimistic or critical or whatever if I sounded that way about this flag. It is ridiculously large for a shop like this, but it fits, and thank you very much. It's a very high quality flag. I think it was outdoors somewhere at a, let's say, an air base, an air show, an airport. Anyway, thanks for the flag. Hey, and if you live in a part of the world that's relatively peaceful and you've got some green space, some nice places to go and enjoy walking, riding, whatever, please don't throw garbage on the ground. Thanks for watching.